Welcome back. Now, just getting ready to test this battery for our desulfating Epsom salt. For those that didn't see part one of the video, this was just taken off a charger. Now, we know this one has a very weak hand or dead cell. I believe it's very weak because if you charge it up, it'll usually hold a charge for a couple hours. But you can see by the voltage there, 10.72 volts. We do indeed have a dead cell, as well as the resistance across the terminals, 759.2 ohm resistance, and 1.95 cold cranking amps. So, I do not believe we can get much worse than that. So, let's pop off the caps here. And sorry for any background noise, we do have a huge three-phase compressor running in the back of our warehouse. Busy, busy, busy. Now, just for heck of it, we can just take a little peek inside the cells here. It's going to be way too hard to show on camera through these little holes here, but all the cells show signs of major sulfation, and I believe this little bugger right here, cell number 2, is the one that is dead, as that one looked really, really horrible. So, similar solution as before. Only this time, I made the solution a little stronger. Figure can't really hurt something that's already shot. If anything, I'll just, if I can actually get this one working, I'll just use this to start my riding lawnmower. Getting a little better at aiming. And that cell that I think might be dead is actually also lower than the rest in fluid, so heck, let's top that sucker off. Caps back on. I think I'm going to have to do a follow-up video with both these batteries after they've been once again recharged. I don't think it's going to improve too much, but let's just see what we get from the start here, and I forgot to shake it up. Already, the resistance has dropped. Voltage is about the same. Cranking amps went up. Looks somewhat promising, and like I said, I did forget to shake it. So, why don't I throw this one on the battery charger too, and see what we end up with for video number 3.